Welcome back. Martin here from Dad's Bedtime Stories. How's everyone doing out there? I have recently made a decision to make these stories as crazy as possible and just get stranger and stranger and stranger unless someone out there writes in an idea for a story of their own. So tonight we're going to be doing episode 134, Attack of the Chickens. If you have an idea for another episode of the podcast, or if you want to hear more about chickens or whatever else I come up with, you can write to me at dad.bedtimestories@gmail.com or fill out the form. It should be in the description below. As usual, if you like the podcast, share it, rate it, and review it, and maybe even join my Patreon. Get as comfy as you can in your bed, close your eyes, and imagine yourself doing the things the kid in the story does. Imagine yourself waking up in your bedroom. Alert, 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 spaceship says. Huh? What do you mean alert? What's going on? Spaceship projects a holographic image in the shape of a TV in front of you. There are dozens of chickens attacking your yard. There's dozens of chickens attacking my yard? What do you mean, you say? I mean, there are dozens of chickens. Okay, like should we call animal control or something, you ask? I don't think that would be appropriate, spaceship answers. You see, this is kind of my fault, spaceship explains. What do you mean it's your fault? Why are you at fault for putting a whole bunch of chickens in my yard, you ask? Well, spaceship explains. You see, I went on an adventure recently, exploring new planets for us to go to. At each planet I found, I put a portal on so we could get to it easily. One of the planets I found was a chicken planet. You found a planet entirely full of chickens? Yes, I found a planet where chickens became the dominant life form. Alright, so I guess we just go collect the chickens and bring them back, you say? I wish it were that easy, spaceship says. The chickens of this planet are self-replicating. Eating small amounts of grass, they begin to duplicate themselves every time they eat a sufficient amount. Spaceship changes the display to a closer-up view of one of the chickens. It's plucking away at the grass, eating as much as it can. And then it starts to wobble a little, and it... Oh my goodness, it splits in half into two chickens? And each chicken begins eating more grass. Uh-oh, you say. This isn't going to be easy. Changer, we're going to need your help. With that, Changer, your shape-shifting dog, perks his head up from the top of the bed and jumps down. Changer, you say. Can you change into something that's good for hurting animals? Changer tilts his head to the side, and then to the other side, and then he begins to shift. He changes himself into a sheepdog. I mean, I guess sheepdogs can probably chase chickens too, you think. You point your special shape-shifting watch at Changer and press the scan button. A light shines over Changer and the watch says, DNA acquired. You press the shape-shifting button that allows you to change in any form you want to as well. And you find yourself slowly transforming into a sheepdog as well. The world around you looks entirely different. Your senses are sharp, more vibrant. Scents are more scenty. There's the earthy aroma of soil, the scent of the grass, and of course, the smell of chickens. You feel agile, more energetic, as if you could run for hours without tiring. With a bark, you and Changer launch yourselves outside into the yard. You begin expertly herding the multiple chickens all around the place. You dart around, nipping at the stragglers and guiding the others to a large, chaotic flock. The ground beneath your paws feels cool and firm, and your sharp ears pick up every rustle and every cluck. However, despite your best efforts, the chickens just keep eating and multiplying. With each bite of grass, another chicken pops into existence, adding to the growing crowd. What started as a somewhat amusing situation is now spiraling out of control. Suddenly, the flock of chickens begin to merge together. Their feathers, their beak, their claws just begin to intertwine into a colossal super chicken. What is going on, you say? Soon, the super chicken stands towering over you, making strange but super loud clucking noises that are way scarier than they were before. Thinking that you might be beat here, you begin to back away. You and Changer run back towards the house to meet Spaceship. Spaceship grows to become its full size and opens the back hatch. You and Changer run in. Spaceship flies up a little bit in the air to keep a safer distance from these super chickens. As you look down at the world below, you notice something alarming. One of the super chickens begins to peck at a nearby tree and starts eating the entire thing, branch by branch, and then rips the trunk out of the ground and eats it too. And, oh no, the chicken begins to shimmer and it starts looking a little melty, and then it splits straight down the middle into two super chickens. Spaceship, I think we need another idea. The longer they stay here, the more super chickens there's gonna be.
I believe I have an idea, Spaceship replies.
A little slot in the wall opens up, and a flute floats out. A simple-looking wooden flute, but it's glowing with a strange light.
I created this based on some ancient earth folklore. They say music can tame beasts. Perhaps it could calm our feathered friends.
You catch the flute in your hand. It feels warm, its energy pulsing in time with your own heartbeat. With a deep breath, you raise the flute to your lips and you begin to blow. A melody fills the air, a tune that resonates with power, otherworldly power. At the sound, the super chickens stop in their tracks. Their gigantic eyes focus on you. And for the first time since this bizarre situation started, there's silence. You play again, your fingers moving instinctively over the flute's holes. This time, the super chickens begin to sway, their heads bobbing in sync with the rhythm. Seeing your chance, you begin to lead them, Pied Piper style, towards the portal. You walk towards the shed that holds the portal, and the chickens follow after you. You see the portal in front of you, its energy looking like flowing water, and you jump inside. You're instantly transported through a wormhole onto another planet. A planet full of even more chickens, but almost everything here has been entirely eaten. No wonder the chickens were so hungry when they got to Earth.
Luckily, as you look behind you, you see the giant super chickens following. They're caught in almost a trance. You continue playing the flute, guiding the super chickens away from the portal, deeper onto the planet. Once you feel you're a safe distance away, you lower the flute. The melody stops, and the super chickens seem to snap out of their daze, blinking and looking around in confusion. You signal spaceship, and in a flash, it transforms to its full size and flies above the huge portal. Giant laser rifles pop out of the top of it, aim down at the portal, and with a giant blast of laser, the portal explodes into millions of pieces. You can't leave a chance that the super chickens will find their way back to Earth after all. Well, that was egg-citing, Spaceship says.
Did you just say egg-citing? You say to Spaceship.
I don't know what you're talking about, Spaceship says. Right. Well, I'm glad we got that figured out. Though we did kind of destroy the easy way home.
Oh, yeah, Spaceship says. That was a poor decision.
Well, let's get going. Spaceship opens the back hatch and you climb inside. Noticing a chicken following you, you quickly turn around and push it off the platform, and then hit the button to close the back hatch as quickly as you can. Spaceship lifts off the ground and gives itself a quick shake just to make sure no chickens are clung on. Then it flies up through the clouds, pierces through the atmosphere, and heads back out into space. You lay down on the couch once again, feeling like that was enough of a day to have for now. You lay down on the couch, you close your eyes, and with each breath, you allow yourself to sink down deeper and deeper into the couch, letting go of any tension in your arms, your legs, your stomach, or your back. And with each breath, you sink down deeper into the couch, and you allow your mind to go where it goes, just focusing on your breath and allowing yourself to drift off to sleep. Good night, everyone.